Now, as part of the centenary commemorations of the First World War, a charity was founded here in the UK called Never Such Innocence. Its aim was to give British children an opportunity to pay tribute to those who were involved in the world's first global conflict through poetry, song and art. An annual competition was set up in these fields and it's now grown to be an international event. This year, children from 43 countries submitted entries, and this week the prize winners have gathered here in London. I'm delighted to be joined here in the studio by Lady Lucy French, the founder and chief executive of Never Such Innocence, as well as two of this year's award winners, Holly Bradley, who's 11 years old and she's from London, and Keda Campbell, a 9-year-old schoolgirl who's come all the way from California. Thank you very much for joining us. Lucy, just tell us a little bit about the project.
Right.
Hello. Yes, we started Never Such Innocence in 2014 to really give
Holly
children...
Holly Brady.
Initially around the United Kingdom, we had no idea it was going to go quite so international. The opportunity to play their part in the centenary of the First World War, to really give them a strong and important voice as the custodians of the future. I sort of felt that the First World War could be very taken up with academics, historians, grown-ups, and I thought it was really important that we give young people a really, really big voice.
And Holly, was this something you knew a lot about?
Well, I realised that there's a lot more I can learn about the First World War after going to a Never Such Innocence event at the Guildhall. So I wanted to try and capture the essence by writing a poem for the competition. And that really made me want to know more and expand my knowledge.
Okay, let's hear the poem.
Death will find you. Oh death, please do not claim me into your abyss of perpetual darkness, where souls forever wander alone, not knowing that the world goes on without them. I know that I am at your doorstep, with every step towards the battlefield, every step that could be my last. You are not welcome here, oh death. That you take us, unwilling as we are, fighting valiantly for our country, but every bullet is your hand reaching out to take us, and you delight as our eyes go glassy.
If afterwards you want to take pictures round the other side in the studio, by all means.
And will fall in the war-torn days and years to come. I do not want you, O death, let me live for my country, but all is the same to you, British or German, Russian or Austro-Hungarian. Whether I was their target or on their side, I pray for those who have succumbed to your clutches. Lucky though I have been, I know now that when I open my eyes, I will find you.
A pretty powerful piece of writing. I think we're all pretty impressed with that in the studio. What were you trying to get across in that poem?
Well, I know that lots and lots of people died and that in these 4 years we've been commemorating and I wanted to capture the essence.
Are in the visual arts, you've done some painting, and an incredibly impressive painting I saw earlier. Just describe it for me.
So it's basically like a field of poppies and then some nice bright blue skies and like the spirits of the airplanes and the pilots flying through the sky. And yeah,
did it take a while?
Well, it took about 2 weeks.
Right.
Yeah.
And was this something, is the history of the First World War taught in schools in California? Not so much by the sound of it. I think Barnaby and Ruth might have a question for you. Ruth, in Germany.
Yeah, I actually saw on the website of
just
Never
to say it's Holly Brady when you thank everyone at the end, Holly Brady.
There are projects with Germany, and I would really like to hear a bit more about that because here this is all the sort of World War One memories. It's so much sort of overshadowed by World War Two, the Nazi era, the German crimes, the Holocaust, and here sort of it's such a tricky issue. Looking at commemorating the dead without looking at German responsibility. So I would be really interested in hearing a bit about your cooperation with German schools.
Yes, well, we're delighted to be working with Germany. It's something that we've wanted to do right from the outset, and we're delighted that in this final year of the centenary it's coming together. I was actually in Berlin a few weeks ago. We're launching a project called Together, and we're inviting children from Germany and the United Kingdom to collaborate, to work together, to create messages of hope and unity for the future. We did a roadshow just outside Essen in January, and it was fantastic to actually go and meet German school children and see how they thought and what they were thinking about this centenary. They came out with some fantastic and really brilliant, thought-provoking, very, very moving work, and I'm delighted to see what's going to come through over the next few weeks before the German-UK deadline.
And tell us about some of the other entries. We're lucky enough to get two of them in here. But
oh, it's been a huge challenge. We were delighted. We received over 7,000 entries from, as you say, 43 countries around the world. So it was incredibly difficult to do that judging process. Every year we've been astonished by the quality and quantity of entries that we've received, but this year I have to say children have done us absolutely proud, and it's their voices that are so incredibly important.
Well, it sounds like a fantastic project. We've got a very packed studio here at New Broadcasting House in London. That's just coming up to the end of the programme. It just remains me to thank all of our guests here, Lady Lucy French, we've got Holly Brady, we've got Kedderton Campbell, and we've got Barnaby Phillips, and we've also got Ruth Kirshner. Thank you very much indeed. That's it for now. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much.